also the issue around the Section 25 of the South African Constitution, which strikes a delicate balance between the interest of existing property owners and the interest of the society as a whole. Looking at the land issues as well, and there's the re-emergence of the land expropriation without compensation issues that have been taking place. But it's not for me to give you the details or just to remind you on the certain aspects of the issue of property or land ownership. Good morning, Sam.
Good morning, X, and the listeners at home. Thank you for the opportunity again.
And then thank you so much for having made the time this month relevant to Human Rights Month, as being reminded of the constitutional booklet that guarantees us our rights as a republic.
Absolutely, X. In fact, this day comes at a very important time for the Foundation for Human Rights, wherein on Monday, the 26th, we launched the largest baseline survey on constitutional rights, awareness and education in South Africa, the first to be done of this nature, and it touched on the question of land and property. One of the keynote speakers was the Deputy Minister of Justice, John Jeffrey, and our director, Yasmin Suga. One of the key findings that came out, it was a survey for 24,897 respondents. In 2011, we did a survey where we worked with about 5,000 respondents, and this time it was more representative across the country. And we found significantly on the issue of land and property, there was a question on land should be returned to black people when it was taken away. And their response about the majority from black people was that about 72% of black people felt that land should be given back to the black people. And disappointingly, less than 45% of the white people said that land should be given back to people after it was taken away forcefully and violently.
Yep. Okay, so there's a minority aspect, minority part of it. So if 45% you say?
Yeah, less than 45%
of white. The white community, yes, saying it should be returned.
Yeah.
But 72% overwhelmingly said it should be returned, of black South Africans.
Yeah, 77% of the black Africans, I think.
Interesting stats. Mm-hmm. Why is land so important? Why is the land issue so important?
Land is important for many reasons. Besides the fact that of the violence in which it was, violence that was used to take land from people, land is important as for rituals, you know, for burials, you know, for growing food, for building households, for worship, for ancestral activities, range of spiritual activities. So land is a very, very basic necessity for a human being to live. You know that every material that we have comes directly from land. So land is a valuable resource. You know, in land we find water, which is also a basic human right. So if people don't have, you know, just land is a very also emotional issue. I've talked about also the spiritual aspect of it. You know, the burials. People don't even have places where they can be buried their loved ones. You know, you have a right to life, but you don't have a place where we can put you to your last days after you've lived life, you know? So it's a very important element, and our people are saying they need land for these various purposes so that they can feel the sense of dignity that was taken away from them. And I think this is the right time in this country that this should happen.
Just on that as well, sometimes there's an argument, Nasara, we'll see, okay, give back land, but then can people actually use the land? Do they know how to use the land? Because it might just remain dormant. It might not have any positive impact towards the people who want the land back. What are the issues around the skills? Do I need skills to use the land? And what are those?
I've just mentioned the range use of land. Let's throw it to the public. Let people define the purpose for getting land back. You know, you cannot deny the South African population learn based on the fact that we're skeptical about the skills that they have. As a country, we've had difficult questions that we dealt with, in particular as we were transitioning towards the democratic era that gave birth to this constitution. We had difficult questions to deal. And I think that through engaging the voices that are marginalized, the voices that need the land, you know, peaceful negotiation, peaceful dialogue, with, and get to hear the voices as to why you need land and how you want to use it. In fact, in this survey, we found that 75% of people living in rural areas were the highest who are setting, saying, for example, they need land back. Mm-hmm. You know? So there is a purpose. I mean, people are living and sitting on top of each other. You know, they are just squatting and they can't even breathe. They can't even, you know, go, you know, in a dignified way to a properly sanitated place, you know, to work with themselves. So it's important that we do recognize the basic necessities of what people need and how land can facilitate, you know, a more well-being and a dignified way of sense of living in South Africa.
Sir, before we close today, I just want to find out, as a Foundation for Human Rights, are you guys able to assist then people, and how are you practically able to assist people in terms of understanding better, or also how to receive assistance regarding issues of land, property?
I spoke about the youth rights, education and innovation, which also has an element of land and how young people or ordinary South African people can access land. So we, in that regard, we do work with people who have expertise in that area to support us in terms of giving the relevant information. Currently, what we have is a referral system where, for example, people can contact the Department of Rural Development on a toll-free number to assist them to access land. But also the municipalities, they have what is called the commonage land, where communities can just go directly to a municipal office and ask where a commonage land is that can be used for the purpose of developing local people who need land at that particular time. It's an easy way to access land at this moment.
Oh, okay. And then in terms of maybe people who seek assistance, you know, I do feel always that, Sarah, we need another platform to discuss these issues, human rights, constitutional obligations as well, with you, because there's so much information that we need to get from you, but just limited time. But in terms of Frido, Foundation for Human Rights, how else maybe can people maybe access you guys? Maybe just to hear more.
We do have an open line, but also to say that we do engage with stakeholders such as Department of Agriculture. As I speak now, we're having a national workshop where we put together civil society to talk about the issue of land. And there's a range of places where Foundation for Human Rights participate and engage their communities or civil society on the issue of land. For example, I've met this toll-free number of the Rural Development Department is 0800-007-095, but also to engage directly with us and find more about any upcoming programs on land. As you're saying, there's a need for more spaces to engage. In fact, our young people whom we work with, they've started, and some are giving us stories of change to say, using the knowledge that I've gained on accessing and use of land, I've managed now to do 1, 2, 3 or access land in this particular way. So it helps to bring even people who work at the land claims court, such as Judge or Advocate Mkoki, Wallace Mkoki, who also works with us and is a commissioner at the Commission for Gender Equality. So, and is a part-time judge at the land claims court. So we are available. Our line is 011-484-0390 for any questions or referral information you might need with regard to this issue.
You said the number is 011?
011-484-0390.
Right. Sarah Motsa, thank you so much. And I'm going to have a chat with Peter. I think we just need to broaden our scope and see where we can post you more and deal more with these issues. But thank you so much for today.
Thank you so much for the opportunity, and we hope one day or soon we'll engage more again.
Please.
It's our pleasure.
Please. Thank you very much.
Welcome.
I love the depth of the information, and I feel the platform